it is. Turning up and there's a camera in your face and there's like a crew of people, four people. There's four people there. They don't say a word to you. It's really weird.
Hi.
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 Hello, boys. How are you?
LA. Why LA?
For me, it has been the perfect escape to go away and do the album. There's a gym on every block and there's a studio on every block. It's like record-making paradise here. You know, Spice Girls were really full on for about 3 years, and like the big climax of that was the world tour. And it came a time in some of the girls' lives have children, you know, which is, we've always been really open and really honest that, you know, we've always known if anybody, you know, met somebody who they wanted to settle down with, someone to be the father of their children, then they were free to go, you know, there's no, oh my God, you can't have children, it ruins the band. That's do you know what I mean? So it was just really, really weird that Melanie and Victoria got pregnant at the same time. I just thought, well, you know, they're having a baby, they're having babies, great, but I'm not having a holiday. I can't have a holiday, I'm a workaholic. So what a great opportunity, you know, to do some things on my own, which is, you know, something we've all always said. Melanie's always wanted to do her own stuff. I've always wanted to do my own stuff. You know, Victoria's got things she wants to do. You know, Emma's doing other stuff as well. So, and Jerry is as well.
Loving you madly will be forever. I see the ocean in your eyes when we're together. There are no boundaries, there are no limits. My heart has been embraced. Now that you're in it, hold me closer to your dreams, closer to your fears, close to hear your laughter. Tears. I wanna be the one you tell your secrets to. All I want is to be closer, closer to you.
Can you imagine waking up and being a Spice Girl? You know, because we're only the same as everyone else, but we are actually one of them. It's pretty daunting, but it's fun. Now I'm dead lucky. It's just like a dream come true. You'd have to pinch yourself all the time. I know it sounds really naff, but it's true. You don't think, I mean, ever since I was a kid, it's all what I've always dreamed of. I mean, but that's what our lives are like. All the Spice Girls, it's just like a dream come true. So many people come up to me in the supermarket and they say, I can't believe it's you. I'm like, why? And like, you do your own shopping. It's like, who else is going to do me shopping? And I love supermarket shopping. But say I go shopping with Emma, like in Bread Cross, isn't it? Then that can be pretty hectic. Or like if it's me and Mel. If there's a couple of us together, then it's pretty manic. But if you're on your own, you learn the tricks of the trade, right? You just keep your eyes down and move quickly. And you can't go shopping with your mates because your mates like to look at all clothes like that and go, oh, that's nice, what do you think that? You can't do that. You see, when people know who you are, what you have to do is know what you want, go in, get it and leave. And that's it. That's the secret. The secret to being a Spice Girl. I love all kinds of music, which I think most people do. You know, if something's good, then you like it. It doesn't matter what genre it is. I'm not, you know, I don't just listen to that. But I do love rock music. I think, because you know what you grow up with, like listening to your mum's records and stuff. There was always a lot of rock in the house. In the house. But, oh God, I don't know. Madonna's always been a really big inspiration to me, not only in music, just her attitude, and I just think she's really intelligent and really talented. Working with Rick Rubin, because he's done great stuff and so diverse as well, He's done, you know, loads of hip-hop. He's done Black Street. He's done loads of rock. He's done all the Beastie Boys stuff. He's just done Red Hot Chili Peppers' new album, which is fantastic.
Thank you.
Very much.
She gives it her all, and she's really committed and is willing to do whatever work. She's not at all. There are many artists who get it good enough and are ready to move on, and she's willing to do whatever it takes and sing it 100 times. And even after it's good, I might say, well, why don't we try something a little different? And some artists are just like, it's fine, leave it alone. And she's, whatever it takes, let's do it. Like, I'll just say, you know, I think this would be better if something else happened here in addition to what we have. And she'll just come up with like three different parts and really make the song a lot better. She's really musically gifted.
You know, at the end of the day, it's my album, it's my track. If I'm not happy with it, then it is my decision. And all the producers, you know, respect that. But, you know, it's a two-way thing. So I'd say, oh, you know, I wouldn't go, that's. I'd just say, I don't like that.